Hey, you guys, let's have some McDonald's, and to drink we'll have some leftover Martinelli's cider from Father's Day. And I'll get this all ready to go, and I'll have a McDonald's story time. We could have half and half and see half the food and half of me. It'd be fun. Oh. I ate it upside down. Now what? Cheers. A reminder, you can make any day a celebration when you have the pretend champagne, the Martinelli's. And we buy these little plastic champagne or toasting glasses from Amazon. And Martinelli's, they even give you this little cap. You don't drink the whole bottle, it's kind of nice. So anyways, I thought of this. I may have mentioned this McDonald's story before. About my first job, and when we first started going to McDonald's in the 60s as a family, honestly and truly, I remember like the regular hamburgers when they were 19 cents and 26 cents. And then after that, prices just became like a big blur. But anyways, I tell you the time my dad made me fill out an application for McDonald's. And he was so sold on McDonald's. The efficiency, the whole everything, the pricing. And I do believe he mentioned, as an employee, you could buy stock, or there was a deal with purchasing stocks. So anyways, I really thought that was the job to have. And of course, I wasn't sure. I was a little bit nervous because it was really a first application for like a real job. And then he made me staple a picture of myself, my little school photo. Oh my goodness, that really stressed me out. And here's like a typical reason. And this is sad when I think back, because I'm sure kids are going through this today, but I didn't want to put a picture on because I was not the typical blonde bombshell or cute girl, high school girl that you think of when you think of Southern California, that I just was not. And that was stressful for me. Well, he made me do it and I did it. these decades later, and I didn't even get an interview. And I always wonder, was it because of my photograph? This plain Jane girl. And that's terrible. But I think it's true. Maybe it's not as true today. Maybe society has gotten beyond that, but what a heavy pressure I felt. So my dad kept assuring me what a nice little application, and I may have had work experience because I had worked at this little burger joint locally. So I had experience. My dad just kept reassuring me. And nothing. No call, no nothing. Or no. And I remember to the best of my recollection, I think my dad hounded me to follow up. And I think I recall calling them back and saying I had handed in an application. And I never heard anything. And it was like a generic response, like, we're not hiring at this time. I said, well, you had a thing out there saying accepting applications. And then I said, we're always accepting applications, but we're not always hiring. So I went back like beginning of high school. Well, I was disappointed. That will always be a big mystery. But I have even maybe gotten an interview if I didn't have my picture on there. Oh, well. So, there was that. I remember my dad just loving the prices of those hamburgers. 19 and 26 cents. We used to go there as a family in the big family truckster. Was a 1969 Ford Econoline van, avocado green. Oh my goodness. And so another reason I wanted to talk about McDonald's is my first job, and my dad just really felt be a nice start. And I remember when our kids started looking for their first job, I remember before it was really even time, thinking they could work. Look at all these food places they could work at, or Target, or the mall. Thinking of all these choices that I really didn't have. Growing up in Simi Valley, we didn't have anything there. If you wanted anything fun, you had to go into the valley. Yes, the San Fernando Valley. You had to go over the hill. So, here's something maybe you parents have not thought of. Lifeguarding is such a wonderful job for a young person. And both our daughters started off as lifeguards as their very first job, and they made top of the line money. And we found out about even lifeguarding because friends of ours, all their kids were lifeguards. You know, our families, we went to the beach together, the kids surfed together. And when I realized they were lifeguards, I thought, oh my goodness, what a perfect first job for a young person. And the girls loved it. And I think my youngest daughter even carried on lifeguarding through college. That was like a part-time job for her at the college she was at the time. It was a junior college, I think. And so I wanted to mention that in case your parents are like stuck for ideas of where to direct your kids. You know what? As I'm saying this out loud, I'm just realizing, do we have any swimming pools open, or are they all closed down because of COVID? Like, are there city pools and parks? Are there pools open? Hopefully they are. And you have to go to, like, this lifeguarding class, and you do a few things. And then if you want to be a lifeguard on a beach, that's an extra class. But it's kind of fun to start off. I got a local pool. So, and of course you have to enjoy swimming. Enjoy that. Enjoy helping others. And it seemed that was the beginning of their, now they're in their mid-30s. Their jobs have always been, you know, with people helping and giving towards others. So anyways, there's that. Yeah. I have to check out the local pool. Because now you have to wear a mask everywhere. They just made that law come back in California. They had TV ads all over with Governor Newsom, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Jerry Brown, Pete Wilson. I have all the California governors got together and made like a commercial or a public or something. So there's that. And you know, you can always get McDonald's through DoorDash or Grubhub. Now, what's kind of fun on DoorDash, when you order McDonald's, you have all these options. You can put extra sauce, extra this, extra that. My brother-in-law, he loads it up with extra everything. And when you feel the Big Mac, it's so heavy. And we don't do that. We just put extra pickles. But it's a nice option you get through the DoorDash app. Whereas if you order in person, you have to like step out of line, and they really make you wait. But anyways, and I have yet to hear that you can catch a virus or COVID through food. Thank goodness for me. What am I going to do if I turn on the news and they say she caught COVID from her restaurant or her food delivery meal? No.